Hi guys, welcome back to alGOdsTutorials. Today we are discussing a question of Spoj named Prata. So question link is given in the description. Please read the question. Let me also explain the question. In the question, we have given an array of size L. And these are the constraints. L represents the size of the array, that is more than equal to 50. P represents the number of datas we have to form, that is more than equal to 1000. And R represents the rating of a code, that lies between 1 to 8. So each cell of this array represents a rating of a code. In the question, we have given that we have a code can form first data in R minutes, second data in 2 R minutes, third data in 3 R minutes, and so on. So in this question, we have to find the minimum time to form the P number of stratas. Please pause the video, think of a solution on your own, and then we will continue with the solution. So let's start with the solution. How are we doing this solution? We are doing the solution by binary search with some modifications. So in binary search, there is one condition, that is the array that is given is sorted, and the time complexity of the binary search is O of log n. So let's see how are you going to do this with binary search. So let's say the starting time that we are going to take in the binary search, or we can say the minimum time to form the pratas is 0 minutes, and the ending time, that is the maximum time to form the pratas, is max rating multiplied by number of pratas we have to form, p plus 1 by 2. So how will it use this formula? Let's see that. So max time is taken by only the max rating cook. So max rating cook form the first data in max rating time, second data in twice into max rating time, third data thrice into max rating time, and so on. So we are taking max rating as common. Since we are defined p pratas, we are telling 2p. This constitutes the sum of natural numbers. So our formula becomes max rating multiplied by p into p plus 1 by 2. So this is how we use this formula. I hope you get it. So in binary search, how are you implementing the binary search? Let's see also that. So let's suppose this is starting time, the minimum time to form the p number of pratas. Let's suppose this is the ending time to form the p number of pratas. In this, we know that our answer lies within this range. So what we will do, we are calculating our mid. So by mid, we are checking that if our answer lies between this range, we are shifting our ending time to mid minus 1, and again checking in this range if our answer lies between this or not. If our answer doesn't lie in between starting to mid range, then we are checking in mid to ending range. If our answer lies between mid to ending range, then we are again calculating the mid and checking if our answer lies between this in this range or in this range. So this is how we are going to do this with binary search. Let's take a small example. Let's say L equals to 3, that is the size of array. Number of pratas we have to form is 3, and the cook rating 1, 3 ml. Let's suppose this is the array. So we are using the binary search. So first condition is that we need to sort this array. So let's sort this array. This is the sorted array.
let's calculate starting time is 0. Let's also go to the ending time. Ending time is going to be 3 at the max rating multiplied by 3 plus 1 by 2. That comes out to be 18. And let's also go to the mid. Mid comes out to be 0 plus 18 by 2. That's 9.
So let's make a table
to check this and evaluate our answer. Let's suppose the cook we have chosen the number of data that has been formed, time taken, and let's also suppose the mid. Okay. So initially the we have chosen the first cook, the number of data are 0, the time is 0 and the mid is now 9. So first cook came from the first data in 1 minute, and that is not equal to 9. If this condition is true, we are again taking this cook to form the second data, and this cook form the second data in 2 minutes, and that is again smaller than equal to 9. This is also true, and this condition is again true. We are again taking this cook to form the third data. This cook form the third data in 3 minutes, and this condition again is true. And since this condition is again true, and we have satisfied our condition to form the three pratas, so now we know that we can form our pratas in 0 to 9 minutes, or we can say in within 9 minutes. So we have formed our pratas in 0 to 9 minutes. So what are we going to do? We are shifting our ending time to mid minus 1, and again evaluating in 0 to 9 range. So let's shift the ending time to mid minus 1. Now our mid is going out to be mid minus 1. That's now 8. Now our range is going to be 0 to 8. And our mid comes out to be 0 plus 8 by 2, that is going to be 4. And since this, we are going to store this time in a variable that is answer. So let's take one more variable, that is answer, and we have found in 6 minutes. So let's again calculate this table. Our initial conditions are same, and now our mid is going to be 4. First cook came from the first strata in 1 minute. That is smaller than equal to 4. This is true. Since this is true, what are you going to do? We are taking this cook again to form the second strata. This cook forms the second strata in 2 minutes, and this is smaller than equal to 4. This condition is again true. We are again going to take this cook to form the third strata. This cook forms the third strata in 3 minutes. And now this condition is false. Since this condition is false, we know that we cannot take this cook to form the third beta. So what are we going to do? We are jumping to the second cook to form the third beta. Second cook came from the third beta in 1 minute, and that is going to be small equals to 4, and this is true. Now there is one trick. The second cook that came here will start forming the beta, third beta, with the first cook. It means the first cook form the first strata in 1 minute, form the second strata in 2 minutes. Let's say the second cook came, form the second strata in 1 minute. Now what do you do? We are not adding this time to this time, because our second cook simultaneously form the first strata with the first cook. So this is how our second cook form the first beta, third beta, we can say the third beta, in 1 minute simultaneously with the first cook. I hope you get it. So now we understand that we can form our betas in 0 to 4 minutes. So what we are going to do, we are shifting our ending time to mid minus 1. So let's check the ending time, 2 minute minus 1. That is now 3. Now our mid is 2. 1. And so this. And our answer is 3. Because the total time taken is 3. So let's see. Our answer is 3. Again making this table and evaluate in 0 to 3 minutes. Since initial condition was same, now our mid is 3. So first cook came, found the first mean. Now our mid is 1. So our first cook came, found the first data in 1 minute, that is not equal to 1, this is true. Since this condition is true, we are again taking this cook to found the second data. First cook came, found the second data in 2 minutes. Since this condition is false, we are not going to take this cook to form the second data. We are jumping to the second cook to form the second data. So second cook came, found the second data in 1 minute. That is now again going to be true. Since we have, you can see that we have taken the second cook and now its timer starts again. We are not adding this time to total time. So now the second cook forms the second data in 1 minute. And this condition is true. Since this condition is true, we are again taking this cook to form the third data. Since it found the third data in 2 minutes, this condition is false. Since this condition is false, we are not going to take this cook to form the third data. We are jumping to the third cook to form the third data. So third cook came, forms the third data in 3 minutes. And this condition is false. Since this condition is true, false, and our array of cook has been iterated and no cook is left to form the third data. So now we know that we cannot form our data in 0 to 3 minute. Sorry, 0 to 1 minute. So what we will do, we are shifting our starting time to mid plus 1. Let's shift our starting time to mid plus 1 and again calculate our mid. So now our starting time is going to be 2 and again we will do mid. Now our mid is 2 and our answer is still 3. Again forming this table and initial condition is same and now our mid is 2. First cook came, found the first data in 1 minute, that is not equal to 2. This is true. Since this condition is true, we are again taking this cook to form the second data. This cook formed the second data in 2 minutes. Now this condition is false. Since this condition is false, we are not going to take this cook to form the second data. We are jumping to the second cook to form the second data. Second cook came, found the second data in 1 minute. And this is not equal to 2. Again, we are not adding this time to total time. So the time or second cook starts from 0. So whenever we are jumping to a new cook, the time starts from 0. It simultaneously cooks the prata from the first or from the previous cooks. So now this condition is true. We are taking this cook again to form the third prata. It found the third prata in 2 minutes. Since this condition is false, we are not going to take this cook to form the third prata. We are jumping to the third cook to form the third prata. Third cook came, found the third prata in 3 minutes. And now this condition is false. Since this condition is false, we are not going to take this cook to form the third prata. And now our array of cook has been iterated and no cook is left to form the third prata. So what we are going to do, we are shifting our starting time to mid plus 1. Or with this, we can conclude that we cannot form our prata in 2 to 2 minutes. So we are shifting our starting time to mid plus 1. Let's shift our starting time to mid plus 1 and again calculate this. Let's change our starting time to mid plus 1. Now it's 3 and our mid is now going to be 3. answer is still same. I am evaluating this table. Initial conditions are same. And now our limit is 3. The first two came from the first data in 1 minute. That is not the question 2. That is not the question 3. This condition is 2. Since this condition is 2, we are going to take this cook again to form the second data. This cook from the second data in 2 minutes. And this condition is 2. Since this condition is again 2, we are going to again take this cook to form the third data. Cook the third data in 3 minutes. Since this condition is false, we are not going to take this cook to form the third data. We are jumping to the second cook to form the third data. So second cook came, formed the third data in 1 minute. And this condition is 2. Now we are not adding this time to the total time. So the second cook formed the third data simultaneously with the first cook. So our total time is now again 3. And we have satisfied our condition to form the three pratas. So now we can know that we can form our pratas in 3 to 3 minutes. So what are we going to do? We are shifting our ending time to mid minus 1. Let's shift our ending time to mid minus 1. Now our ending time is going to be 2. And let's not do mid. Change our answer to 3 to 3. Answer is still 3. And now we can see that our starting time is 3, our ending time is 2. And since this starting time is greater than ending time, the while loop condition of the binary search is starting smaller than equals to ending. Since this condition is valid, this condition came out of the loop and our answer is 3. So we have calculated our answer using binary search and it came out to be 3 to form the 3 pratas in this example. So answer is 3. Let's talk about the time complexity also. The time complexity of this question is, so for every iteration, let's say we have to iterate over the whole array, that is L. For every iteration, we have to search, and for binary search, it takes O of log N. So it multiplies with log O of log L. And our time of iteration is going to have to be O of L log N. So now we have solved this question, and I hope you understand the concept of the Prata. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment section, and the code is given in the description. And there's two more questions of this type, that is book allocation problem and the aggressive cop. Please try this question also. We are giving the link of this question also in the description. Thank you for watching our video. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel alGOdsTutorials. Thank you.